There's the member for Wajir North, Honorable Abdisalan.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, let me confirm that Marsabit County is my neighbor. And at times, the conflicts even happening in Marsabit happen within my constituency. I want to request members, I want to plead with members to be extremely careful and to sober up as much as we are making decisions here. The decisions we are making here can lead to loss of lives or can save lives. When I look at the contribution of the members, you are divided into your different political groups. You are not bothered about the lives and well-being of the people of Marsabit County. I want to urge you to sober up and make decisions in a very sober way. Mr. Speaker, I want to confirm once again that I have worked with the Kenya Red Cross Society as the regional manager for Northern Kenya. And Mr. Speaker, I have had a meeting with both communities during my tenure as regional manager. More than 5-6 meetings at Moyale and as well as several meetings here at Nairobi. I'm aware of a lot of information that members who are making contributions on the floor of this house are not aware. That notwithstanding, when I come to the real issue, Mr. Speaker, number one, I believe in the fact that the wearer knows where the shoe pins. They were better positioned to solve this issue, not on the floor of this house, but outside the floor of this house. But that said, still a petition was brought to this house. The committee have made their independent investigations, a report submitted. Now, the petitioner is making an amendment to a magnitude that changed the content of this report totally. Now, are we in a position to accept the report, which is no longer the report of the committee now, but the report of the petitioner? I will request my sister from Isiolo County to be cognizant of the fact that I am close to Marsabit more than her, and she should respect that fact. Mr. Speaker, number one, this is a house where justice is observed. We must be fair. Mistakes have happened. Now that mistakes have happened, shall we continue with the mistakes made? Or we should stop at a certain position and ask ourselves, isn't it the right time to correct? We should not be creating dangerous precedences where a petitioner can make an amendment to a magnitude that changed the entire report. Under Article 119, I appreciate that any person has a right to petition Parliament to consider any matter within its authority. But we must put safeguards in place to ensure that it is not mutilated to a level where we are causing confusion, where we are causing conflicts, where we are becoming war makers other than lawmakers. Mr. Speaker, I think this is a very difficult moment. It is a moment for you to go back to the drawing board. It is a moment for you to make a decision that will save lives. It is a moment for you to create a precedent where members cannot mutilate the commit the report of a departmental committee to a level where they want. Mr. Speaker, in the event we put this question to members and make a decision today, we will be creating very dangerous precedents that will haunt all of us. Mr. Speaker, it may be bitter, but we must swallow the bitter pill, and we must go back to the drawing board and make a decision that will save lives and livelihood of the people of Marsabit County. I submit.
Now, honourable members, because you know now, Honourable Abdisalan decided to go and address. You are addressing the contents of the report and not this aspect which was brought out. Honorable Wanga, I will allow you just 3 minutes.
Thank you, Honorable Speaker. Honorable Speaker, I listened as Honorable Mbadi raised the issue of deferment. And what he was calling upon you was the fact that this matter is emotive. It is a matter that whichever way it goes can actually escalate conflict rather than reduce it. I listened to Honorable former Leader of Majority speaking. He spoke about winners, that somebody will win and another person will win and so on. So Honorable Speaker, I want to just bring your attention to Article 10 of the Constitution and the fact that we as state officers, including yourself, are called upon in the performance of our duties, not to just look at the letter of the law of what is happening, but also to look at our national values that includes national unity. How are our decisions promoting national unity? And this is what I wanted to bring to your attention, Speaker. In addition to the issues that have been raised by our colleagues, Honorable Kaluma, Honorable Otiende, and the others who are raising constitutional matters, can we defer this matter? Honorable Speaker, earlier on the chair, you spoke to the issue that we are coming closer to election and therefore more prone to conflict. This is not the same year that we were in 2018 when we could make a decision and it just goes. As we moved closer to election, we are also very, very likely to spark conflict with whatever decision that we make. We are dealing with conflict in Laikipia. We are dealing with conflict in several parts of this country. So, Honorable Speaker, I just wanted to, on the basis of Article 10, ask you to use Standing Order Number 1 to defer this.